head to Azusa, California, and talk to Chris, who listens on the Catholic Answers app. Welcome to the program, Chris.
Hey, how's it going?
Just fine, and even finer for hearing from someone from Azusa. A to Z USA, I understand, is the etymology of the name, correct?
Yeah,
and,
right.
if you've ever heard the Jack Benny show, you know the famous train station announcement for a train is leaving for Anaheim, Azusa, and Cucamonga.
Oh, that's
right. So that's always big in old-time radio. So what can we do for you today, Chris?
My question is plastic surgery to sexualize yourself considered a sin? I guess... Mm. Considered immodest if, say, any type of plastic surgery dealing with breast surgery augmentation or anything in that nature.
Okay, well, it's going to depend on the situation. It's not going to surgery to increase your attractiveness is not going to be automatically sinful. But there will be cases where it is sinful. And so the question is how to sort out the difference. Well, in let's talk one extreme as a way of kind of setting the parameters. There are people who are deformed, either because they've been born that way or because they've suffered an accident of some kind. And they can be deformed in various ways. They could be, have a deformed face. They could have a deformed torso. They could have other body parts that are deformed. And to say, I want to look better, you know, I if there's something I can do that'll make me look better, that's a reasonable desire. You know, God designed us to look a certain way as human beings, and it, because of the accidents of birth or the accidents in the literal sense of life, we may not look that way. And it's reasonable to say, you know, I want to look more like God would like a human being to look, or the way God designed human beings to look, the way I'll look, or more like the way I'll look in the resurrection when I won't have the limitations and defects that I have in this life. It's reasonable to use medical technology and medical techniques to help achieve as much of that in this life as possible. And so various people undergo reconstructive surgery to help them look better, whether it's in the face or in the torso or anywhere else in their body. That's clearly reasonable. So using that example, we can say, okay, it's reasonable in some cases to use surgical techniques to help look better. Well, okay, what about looking better sexually? Well, there's nothing wrong with human sexuality. It's an intrinsically good thing. God designed it. And so... There wouldn't be anything wrong in principle with increasing one's sexual attractiveness. Notice I said in principle. So I can imagine situations in which someone might say, you know, I want to look more attractive for my spouse, or I want to look more sexually attractive just so I feel better about myself. Those are understandable desires, and in some cases that's going to be reasonable. On the other hand, human nature is disordered as a result of original sin, and we have temptations that are not good, and that can include sexual temptations in a special way. That sexual temptations are a big problem in our culture. And so if someone said, I want to look more sexual to the world, I just want to turn men on or something, well, okay, that's disordered. That's not wanting to look better for your spouse or look better just to feel good about yourself. That's something disordered. If you're saying, I want to sexually stimulate other people and I'm going to have this surgery to do it, well, it reflects a disordered sexuality. And so in that case, I would say it would be objectively sinful to use plastic surgery to achieve those goals. And I can imagine even more extreme situations, like someone saying, okay, I'm a prostitute, I make my money this way, and so I want to have plastic surgery to further sexualize myself so I can make more money by further objectifying my body. That would result in an even greater disorder, and I would say even greater objective sinfulness. So I would say it's going to depend on the motive. It's also going to depend on the circumstances. Whereas it could be good to look, be more attractive and for your spouse and to maybe feel better about yourself, those are intrinsically worthy goals, but they have to be set among the other aspects of life. Like, can you really afford this? Or do you need to be devoting the money you would spend on surgery to a more pressing priority, like, say, the education of your children? Those are important questions as well. And so you're going to need to look both at the motive and at the circumstances, but the principle of just using medical techniques to look better, and including looking sexually more attractive, it's not in principle wrong, but there are some sharp boundaries here that we need to be aware of and we need to take into account. Does that help, Chris?
Yeah, it does.
Okay. Listen,
all right, thank you
for giving us a call.